Hello, my name is Virginia Field. I'm in Physics 223, and today I will be doing problem 2 off of homework 10. In this problem, a 1.4 kilogram grinding wheel is in the form of a solid cylinder of radius 0.1 meters. And for the first part, it wants us to find what the constant torque will bring it from rest to an angular speed of 1,150 revolutions per minute in 2 seconds. So first we have to take the 1,150 revolutions and turn that into angular speed. And we do that by doing 2 pi over 60 seconds, so we get 120.4 radians per second. So the next thing we want to do is we want to know what the torque is, so let's take a look at the equation. It's equal to the moment of inertia times the acceleration. To find the moment of inertia, it is simply 1/2 times the mass times the radius squared. We're given in the problem the mass is 1.40 kilograms and the radius is 0.1 meters. So we find the moment of inertia to be 0.007. The acceleration, we can just use one of our kinematic equations, where final velocity is equal to initial velocity, and the problem tells us that it's starting at rest, plus the acceleration times the time. So we plug everything in there, and we get an acceleration of 60.2 radians per second squared. Now we can take both of those, the moment of inertia and the acceleration, finally multiply it together. We got inertia, moment inertia, and then we have acceleration, and we get a torque here of 0.421 newton meters. Next part asks us what is the angle during this time, which is, we can just use one of our kinematic equations. In this case, we don't use x for displacement, we use the angle, so we turn x to the angle theta. So we just plug in velocity, initial velocity 0, final velocity, which we found 120.4 radians per second. Multiply it by 2, which we're given into the problem. The 2's cancel out, and our answer for the change in angle is 120.4 radians. The next part of the problem asks us to use this equation, work equals torque times the change in the angle, to find the work. So here we have 0.421 newton meters times 120 radians, so we find our work to be 50.6 joules. So the next part of this problem asks us what the kinetic energy is when it's rotating at 1,150 revolutions per minute. We're given the angular speed. We already found that 120 radians per second. Our moment of inertia here is 0.07 kilograms times meter squared. So our equation for kinetic energy is 1/2 mv squared for translational, and then 1/2 moment inertia times the angular speed squared. Here we don't have any translational energy, so we're just solving for this part of the equation. We plug it in, and we get our kinetic energy to be 50.4 joules. So actually, our kinetic energy and our work were the same, which makes sense because work is just the change in kinetic energy.